الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. This next section of this series in paradise is about people visiting each other. This is a much awaited topic. How will people visit each other in paradise? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah As-Saffat, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون قال قائل منهم إني كان لي قرين يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَدِينُونَ قَالَ هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ فَاطَّلَعَ فَرَآهُ فِي سَوَاءِ الْجَحِيمِ قَالَ تَاللَّهِ إِنْ كِدْتَ لَتُرْدِينَ وَلَوْلَا نِعْمَةُ رَبِّي لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُحْضَرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the people of paradise. They will be visiting one another and having a discussion. And in between all of that, clearly the discussion about this world will arise. Something to do with the past, which is the world. And people will reminisce over the memories of this dunya. So as they're discussing, discussing these things, it will. One of them will suddenly say, "You know, I had a friend in the world. There was an associate of mine, and he used to reject the resurrection. He used to reject this hereafter. And then." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relates this in the Quran as to what this particular denier would say. أَإِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ. Do you really believe this? Do you really believe that we are going to be resurrected and then we're going to be rewarded or punished for our deeds and actions? And we're going to have to undergo some kind of reckoning after we have become completely rotten, our bones have turned into dust, they've become completely decomposed, maybe cremated in some cases. So that's what's going to happen to us. So then, this is what Allah says, أَإِنَّكَ لَمِنَ الْمُصَدِّقِينَ أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَإِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ أَإِنَّا لَمَدِينُونَ. We're going to be coming back to be rewarded or punished, recompensed for whatever we do. قَالَ هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ. So this is where قَالَ هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ. Do you want to look where your friend is? Do you want to see in hellfire where this person is and what's happening to him? So who makes this statement? According to the first interpretation, this is the person he's speaking to. You know, the two people are having this discourse. One of them has this friend or had this friend. So the other one says, do you want to see where he is? Do you want to take a look? هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ. The other opinion is that the angels will come in and say, at this point, do you want to take a look? And a third opinion is that this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who will say that. هَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُطَّلِعُونَ. However, the first opinion seems to be the strongest in this case, because that is the whole indication and the context is what that is all about. So, do you want to take a look? Ka'b, in the midst of this, there's a small narration from Ka'b, says that between Jannah and Hellfire, there's a door. We actually read a hadith about this before, that in every paradise, they will have four doors or four access points, and one of them will be out looking towards the Hellfire. So when a person wants to feel good about where he is, he'll look in Hellfire. In this case, Ka'b says that between Jannah and Jahannam is a window. is a vantage point, a vista point. When a believer wants to look at his enemy, that was his enemy in the dunya, he will look from that window and he'll be able to see them. So, فَطَّلَعَ فَرَآهُ فِي سَوَاءِ الْجَحِيمِ. He will see him in the middle of the hellfire, this friend of his. And then he will say that if it hadn't been for the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had shown me the truth, then I would not have recognized and known the truth. He says that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not been able to show me this friend of mine and point him out to me, I would not have been able to recognize him. Because his entire body, his skin, his face, his color, and everything would have gone through a severe change, an alteration because of the fire. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, Allah relates here, تَاللَّهِ إِن كِتَّ لَتُرْدِينَ وَلَوْلَا نِعْمَةُ رَبِّي لَكُنْتُ مِنَ الْمُحْضَرِينَ. By Allah, it was very close. So this person, it's relating what this person is saying. As he's looking at this person, he's saying, by Allah, you are very close to misguiding me. You are very close to causing me this destruction as well. And if it hadn't been for the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had bestowed his bounty upon me and guided me, then I would have also be one of those who would be present in this punishment of yours. So that's what these verses of Surah As-Saffat relate. Then in Surah At-Tur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, similar, وَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ قَالُوا إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَوَقَانَا عَذَابَ السَّمُومِ إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلُ نَدْعُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْبَرُّ الرَّحِيمُ. They will look at each other and they will ask. They will say that we used to be in our families, among our families. We used to be among our families in fear, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed His bounty upon us and He protected us from this evil punishment. And before this, we used to call unto Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most giving, most merciful one. Tabarani has a narration here related that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked. So from these Quranic verses, we're understanding that there are some meetings and discussions taking place among friends, among people. So that's indicated directly in the Quran. In the hadith now, Tabarani has a narration where he says, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, will the people of Jannah visit each other? And now we're getting some understanding of the hierarchy here. He will say that, yes, the higher people will visit the lower people. The higher ones of the higher stages will visit the lower ones. The lower ones will not visit the higher ones. So it looks like first class can come into second class or coach class. But like here, you can't go from coach into first and second, they stop you. Except, there is an exception here though, which is the beautiful part. Except those who used to love each other for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will be able to go wherever they want to visit on these camels that will be these special camels. They will be able to go upon them. Tabarani has another narration, says that, إِنَّ أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ يَتَزَاوَرُونَ عَلَى النَّجَائِبِ. The people of Jannah will be able to visit one another on camels. Najaib, Najib. So what we understand from this is that people of paradise will visit each other. They will want to visit one another. And by this, obviously, when you visit, we are social creatures, so we enjoy a bit of social interaction. It says by that, their pleasure, their their happiness will even increase more. That's why Haritha said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Kayfa asbahta ya Haritha? How was your morning? How did you spend your morning? Meaning, how's your morning, O Haritha? So Haritha said to him, Asbahtu mu'minan haqqan. I spent my mu'min as a true believer. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, look, every, you know when you say as a true believer, every true thing has a reality. When you say something is true, that I am truly a believer, that has a reality. What is the reality of your faith? فَمَا حَقِيقَةُ إِيمَانِكَ What is the reality of your faith? So he said that I've recognized, or my nafs has recognized myself from the dunya, the distinction between this world and the hereafter. So I have awakened during the nights. I have spent the nights awake. And I have spent the days thirsty, essentially fasting and praying. And it is as though I am looking at the throne of my Lord manifest. And it is as though I can see the people of Jannah visiting one another. What a beautiful vision. It is though I can see a vision of the people of Jannah visiting one another. And I can see a vision of the people of Hellfire being punished in it. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عَبْدٌ نَوَّرَ اللَّهُ قَلْبَهُ This is a servant who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has illuminated his heart. We have another narration from Ibn Abi Dunya. Anas radiallahu anhu relates, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the people of Jannah will enter into Jannah, into the gardens, and there will be a desire of some brothers to visit others, so his sarir, his throne, his seating place, it means some kind of special vehicle that he will be given, a special flying carpet, whatever it may be. فَيَسِيرُ السَّرِيرُ هَذَا إِلَى سَرِيرِ هَذَا Sarir, the platform he sits on, the throne, the special seating of his will go and meet up with the seating of the other person. Until they will gather together somewhere, there'll be some the special place of gathering, it seems. And he will say, and the conversation now, one of them will say to the other, do you know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave us? Like, do you know when we made it, when Allah forgave us? So the other one will say, yes, when we were in such and such a place. When we were in such and such a place, and we had asked Allah, we had made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He forgave us. So it looks like in paradise we'll have a clear vision of how our deeds helped us. But it also looks like these two brothers, these two people, friends, companions, they seem to have got this together because he's saying, do you know when Allah forgave us? It looks like they were very good friends for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you remember from our series on the Sha'rani's Adab al-Suhbah, in the beginning that section on the benefits and the virtues of brotherhood, there were some huge benefits there of people coming together and having special places in paradise because they used to love one another for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's another narration that is related from Shufay ibn Mati', that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that part of the bounties of the people of Jannah is that they will get to visit one another on different forms of conveyances, camels. And then there's a lengthy hadith that we should look at here. It carries on. They will be brought a horse in paradise that will already be saddled. It will be prepared for travel. This horse will not, this is very interesting, this horse will not have to defecate or urinate. Right? So again, it could be a horse or it could be something else, a vehicle of some sort. They will get upon it and it will take them to wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Suddenly, what will come upon them will be something like a cloud. And within that cloud, or within what looks like a cloud, there will be within it that which no eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard the likes of. They will say, some kind of great vision they will have of these things, they will say, shower down upon us. It will shower upon them until it will go way beyond what they would have ever expected to come from there. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a wind, which will not be a harmful wind. It will blow and spray on them musk from both their right side and from their left side. So it looks like that this is a special beauty shower. And then you get sprayed with this beautiful musk of paradise. This musk will, this spray will reach both the foreheads, you know, the heads of their animals, of their horses, and into their, you know, the all parts of their animal will be benefiting from this spray, and also every person from among them will have long hair as much as he desires. Each person there will have long hair as much as he desires, a jumma. So jumma is long hair that generally comes to the earlobes. He says everyone will have hair as much as he desires. That musk will adhere to the hair because generally, you know, when they do bakhur, this is what happens. They put it in their hair, they put it under their clothes, so it kind of infuses within it. So it will infuse their hair, their clothing and everything. And then after that, they will carry on until they will get to another place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. And there suddenly they will see a woman that is calling. Now this is for each person. They will see a woman that is calling. Ya Abdullah, O servant of Allah, don't you have any desire for us? He will say, what are you? What are you? Who are you? Ma anti wa man anti. Said, I am your wife. I am your spouse and your beloved. It looks like they'll discover new spouses in various different places, it seems. So he said, Ma kuntu alimtu bi makanik. I didn't know that you were here. I didn't know this was your place. I didn't know. So she will say, Don't you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَّا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ. That no nafs, no person knows that which has been hidden for them from the gladness of their eyes, something that will gladden their eyes, جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, which is a source of reward, which is a reward for what they used to do, for what they used to do, this is in Surah Al-Sajdah. So then he will respond, yes, of course, by my Lord. However, he will be then distracted from her for 40 autumns, 40 years, that length of time. He will not even look anywhere else. He won't look towards her. He won't do anything. And it will be all the other bounties and the honor that will be provided there will suddenly distract him. So it looks like they're taken on this special voyage and or this journey, this shopping journey, this enjoyment journey, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is providing all of these things. Now, how is a person ever going to get bored? Some of these distractions will be such that they will occupy you for such a long time and you've got enough time anyway. There's another narration related from Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. He said that the people of Jannah will be visiting one another on camels of good stock, on these really beautiful pedigree camels that will have some whiteness within their dark color. This is al-Is al-Jun, that's what they call in Arabic. And they will have these very special seating put on them that will be made of a special wood, Rihal al-Mais. Its hooves will spray up musk, the dust of musk, and the stirrup, the saddle of each one of these will be superior to the dunya and everything within it. That's how beautiful it is. Ibn Abi Dunya has another narration from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Again, this is an interesting narration. It says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked Jibreel alayhi salam about this verse. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَن فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَن فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَن شَاءَ اللَّهِ. When the trumpet will be blown, those in the heavens and those on the earth will swoon, except those that Allah wishes. Be some people who will be made exempt from that swooning, and thus the trumpet will not affect them. So he asked Jibreel alayhi salam about this, and he said, these are the shuhada. These are the martyrs whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect. They will have their swords with them, and they will be around the throne. The angels that will come to them from the gathering place with camels made out of ruby, or studded with ruby, or whatever that is, or maybe it's something else. And explains a number of other beautiful things about these camels, that their strings will be made of this pearl and all of these other things. The saddle will be of gold, and there will be pure silks and brocade and everything on it. وَنَمَارِقُهَا أَلْيَنُ مِنَ الْحَرِيرِ. Right? Some of the cloth that's used there will be softer than silk. And they can travel as far as the sight can see. So they will travel around Jannah on horses, and after they've had quite a bit of time going around and enjoying their sightseeing, they will suddenly say, come on, take us to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is deciding and the reckoning is taking place between the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be very satisfied with them. It basically says Allah will laugh for them. And then it says whenever Allah laughs at anybody, meaning in a positive way, then that person is not going to have to undergo a reckoning. So this is very special. Ibn Abi Dunya has another narration from Ali radiallahu anhu. He says that I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, in Jannah there is a tree. From the upper part of it will come garments. Remember we read earlier that garments of paradise will be made from trees. They will be produced from trees. And from the bottom will come out a horse, again, this beautiful horse that's been specially decorated with all of these rubies and pearls and so on. It will not defecate or urinate. And that's what makes me again think that this is some kind of vehicle. It will have wings, and it can travel as far as the sight can see. So this is some kind of flying vehicle. The people of Jannah will get on top of it, and it will travel with them wherever they want. So now people on the who are lower than them will ask, oh Allah, oh my Lord, how have these people reached this honor? They'll see them traveling around. They'll say, how have these people reached this honor? So it will be said to them that they used to pray at night, and you used to be sleeping. They used to fast, and you used to be eating. They used to be spending, and you were miserly and withholding. And they were fighting while you were acting cowardly. They were striving and fighting while you were acting cowardly. So that's, we do understand here that this gives us, there's this question about how the lower people will see the higher people. Well, this gives us some indication. Of course, all of this ziyarah of visiting one another is very pleasurable and very nice and exciting and very delightful. But the more delightful thing will be seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in paradise. And that is something that we will be looking at in another chapter. Now, the next section is about the special market of paradise. People love their markets, they like shopping. They like going to get new things. Essentially, a market is a place where you go and buy new things. The souq, this is what it is, the souq of Jannah. This is the market of Jannah. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created for the people there. So now the first narration here is related by Imam Muslim in his Sahih. From Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that inna fil jannati lasuqan ya'tunaha kulla jumu'ah. There is a market in paradise that people will attend once a week. The wind from the north will blow, and it will spray up into their faces and their clothes. And by that, they will increase in their beauty and handsomeness. So you'll go there and suddenly you'll feel this wind like a spray of some sort. And it will be to enhance you. I don't know what's going to be in there, but it's going to enhance you. It's going to increase the beauty. They will then go back to their families, and they would have become enhanced in their beauty. Their families will say to them, Wallahi, after leaving us, you've just suddenly become more beautiful. And they will say, you, by Allah, have also increased. So they will both increase. Imam Ahmad has related in his Musnad that in there will be these mounds of musk. When they come out, they will spray upon them. It's a well-organized system with everything, nothing left to chance. Ibn Abi Asim relates in Kitab al-Sunnah from Sa'id al-Musayyib that he met Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. The Tabi'i met the Sahabi. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, As'alullah an yajma'a bayni wa baynaka fi suq al-jannah. What a wonderful dua. You meet somebody, you say, Ya Ammar, that's your name, right? I ask Allah that He gather between us, He gather us together, He make us meet in the market of Jannah. So Sa'id says, there's a market in Jannah? So he said, yes. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed me that the people of Jannah, when they enter into Jannah, they will be placed in Jannah according to their deeds. According to their actions, they will be placed in Jannah. However, they will then be permitted as much as is the time of a Friday. Right, from the dunya days, that long, 24 hours, whatever, right? That is how long they'll be allowed to go to Jannah. They will be given special permission, and thus in that time they will visit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the time they'll visit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, go to do Jumu'ah, and thus in paradise the reflection of that is you go to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who don't do Jumu'ah, subhanallah, they're going to be deprived. Anyway, the arsh and the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will loom in front of them. And this will be in an orchard from one of the Riyadul Jannah. These huge thrones and seating places will be prepared for them that will be made of light. Some of them will be made of light. Some of them will be made of pearl. Some of them will be made of sapphire. Some of them will be made of ruby. Some of them will be made of gold. Some made of silver. The lower people, the lower level people, and remember, there is no inferior person in paradise. It says that here. This is not me saying. It says, وَيَجْلِسُ أَدْنَاهُمْ وَمَا فِيهَا دَنِيٌّ. The lower level people, but remember, there is no inferior person there. They're all good, but it's just relative. That person will sit on mounds of musk and camphor. And they will not think that the people who are on these special seating places are better than them. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, Sa'il ibn Musayyib asked him, will we see our Lord in Jannah? So he said, yes, of course. Do you have any doubt when you look at the sun or the moon during the 14th night? He said, no. He says, likewise, you will see your Lord, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. In fact, he says, in that gathering, when you go to visit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every single person will be visited by Allah or addressed by Allah. Every single person will have a private interaction with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much so that he will say, O Fulan ibn Fulan, O such and such a person, do you remember the day when you did this and that? And he will remind him of certain of his deeds in the world. And the person will say, yes, of course. Haven't you forgiven me though, my Lord? And he'll say, of course. It is by my maghfirah and forgiveness that you've reached this stage. While they're in that discourse, suddenly there will be like a cloud-like thing that will suddenly overcome them. Suddenly will come over them, and it will shower down and spray on them a beautiful fragrance, tiban, that they would never have smelt before. So every week in that discussion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that honor you will be given and sprayed with a new perfume. Then the person will say, oh my Lord, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Actually, our Lord will say, go, stand up and go and enjoy that which I have prepared for you of all of this honor, and go and take whatever you want. So then they'll come to the market. Now they will arrive at the market until the angels will surround them. And in that market is what the eyes have never seen before. Ears have never heard the likes of before. In fact, things there have never even occurred to your heart, it will say. So, now for us will be carried whatever we desire. And nothing is sold in that market for money. Nothing is exchanged for money in that market. Nothing is sold. It's all to take, whatever you want. And it is in this market that the people of Jannah will visit and see one another. They will interact with one another. Hence, a person will come who has on himself a more expensive and premium apparel or garments, a robe. He will see those who have a lesser quality. And again he says, وَمَا فِيهِمْ دَنِيٌّ. That remember, there is no inferior person here. It's just all relative, it's comparative. So the person with better apparel will see somebody with a lesser apparel. And of course, they will make an impression on one another. However, as soon as they finish speaking, that other person who had the lesser garments will have better garments than that. And the reason for it is that in paradise, nobody should grieve by seeing somebody else. That will be used to give them better, but then probably that person will get even better. But nobody has to grieve in paradise. So maybe this is the way that you're satisfied with what you have, but you still have less than somebody else. But to you, it's the best, because now you've got better than what you had before from what you saw. وَذَٰلِكَ أَنَّهُ لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ أَنْ يَحْزُنَ فِيهِ. Nobody. يَحْزِنَ فِيهِ. Nobody should be miserable in paradise. Nobody should grieve in paradise. Anyway, then he says that then we will return to our abodes, and our spouses there will visit us, will see us, will meet us, and they will say, مَرْحَبًا وَأَهْلًا بِمُحِبِّنَا. It's just all full of love. Nobody's ever angry. Nobody's ever sad. Nobody's too tired after cooking. Right? Nobody's too tired after working on the car, whatever it is. Nobody's tired after work, coming home and getting angry. It's just, everybody's just full enjoyment. Time, enough time for each other. And then the spouse will say, you have just come. And now you have such beauty and such fragrance that is way superior to what you had left with. It's not that they had gone smelly or something. They'd already had some, now it's just come back with something better. So they said, yes, we've just sat with our Lord Al-Jabbar today. Tabaraka wa ta'ala, most blessed and most high is He. And it is our absolute worth and right that if we've met Him like this, that we come back in the way that we've come back and return. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak relates from Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. He says basically that Sulaiman al-Taymi related to us from Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu that the people of Jannah will say that, come on, let's go to the market. So they will go and they will first come upon these mounds of musk. When they come back to their families, they will say that, they'll say the same thing, you've just come back with better fragrance. So they said, yes, you've just come back. They will say themselves that it looks like we've got better fragrance than we left with. So when they come back, their spouses will say to them that you have better fragrance than what you left us with. Al-Hafidh Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Hadrami, he relates with this chain from Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu. Once the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came upon us while we were, he came out of his house. And we were sitting there gathered, said, O group of Muslimin, in paradise is a market in which nothing is sold or bought except faces. Right. Whichever man or woman wants a better, more handsome, more pretty, and more beautiful look, then they will go and take from there. So this is a special place in paradise, apparently, that you will go there just to get a facelift. Right. But no Botox, just beautiful facelift.